Welcome to the Morning Offering, your daily call to prayer. Pray with us every day right here on the podcast and in your inbox. Learn more at morningoffering.com.
Hey, y'all. Welcome to your Morning Offering. My name is Father Brad Doyle, and today is October 20th, the 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Let's pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Jesus, through the Immaculate Heart of Mary, I offer you my prayers, works, joys, and sufferings of this day, for all the intentions of your Sacred Heart, in union with the holy sacrifice of the Mass throughout the world, for the salvation of souls, the reparation of sins, the reunion of all Christians, and in particular the intentions of the Holy Father this month. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Okay, in our first reading this Sunday, it comes from the book of Isaiah, a particular part of that book, and it's called The Suffering Servant. So there's a couple of chapters now towards the end, latter part of Isaiah. It's called The Suffering Servant, and it's a prophecy of a future servant of mankind who will suffer. And a lot of the prophecies, a lot of the explanations of how this future sufferer will suffer are fulfilled by, guess who? Not me. Not you. Well, kind of, because we participate in Christ's suffering, but Jesus. Jesus fulfills the suffering servant. And what we read today reminded me of a change in the Missal in 2011. So I'm going to read first the text. This is from Isaiah 53. It says, "Because of his affliction, he shall see the light in fullness of days. Through his suffering, my servant shall justify many, and their guilt he shall bear." And so obviously Jesus fulfills that through his suffering. He justifies many, but that word many can throw some people off. They think, didn't Jesus come to die for all of us? Doesn't he desire the salvation of all people? Why do we say many? Why did Isaiah say many? Well, when Jesus fulfilled this, he said at the Last Supper in the institution narrative, this is from the Gospel of Mark. He says, "And he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank of it. And he said to them, 'This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many.'" Now, before the 2011 translation change, it was translated as "all." And I think this was a desire by the translators to highlight, maybe express that Jesus did desire to die for all. But the problem was, that's not what he said. We know that theologically he desires all people to be saved, and he gives grace sufficient for all people's salvation. But he said many. And I think this might be a little nod to the fact that we have free will. That even though he reaches out, he comes to us, he lays himself on the altar, he dies for us, we must say yes. We must say fiat, like Our Lady said. We must say yes, like the 11 apostles did. And Judas said no. And it'd be better for that person if he were never born. As Catholics, especially as the church, it's our responsibility to give what Jesus gave us, not what we want to give, not what we think is really nice, but instead to give the truth. And the truth is, God does love you no matter where you are, no matter what you've done. But he also wants to be in relationship. And so he offers, sometimes we reject, and that's sad. But you can always turn back to him. This has been your Morning Offering. If it was helpful for you, go to morningoffering.com and sign up. We'll be in your inbox every morning. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Thanks for listening today. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. The Morning Offering is a production of Good Catholic, the media division of The Catholic Company. For more faith-filled podcasts and videos, visit goodcatholic.com.